Alrighty, so many people have been asking me to do top 10s, top 5s, top lists of any sort, and I'm going to be honest, I've been avoiding doing them because a lot of the times when a YouTuber or someone on Instagram in the coaster community comes up with a top list, they end up getting a lot of slack for their opinions. So I just want to stress right off the bat that these are my opinions. My top 5 list for Canada's Wonderland's top 5 is going to be based off of multiple factors. I'm going off of comfort, theming, overall package. Again, Canada's Wonderland's a family park, and I really like family rides. A lot of the times, I like to call myself a theme park enthusiast versus a roller coaster enthusiast. So hopefully that helps you understand why I make this top 5 list the way I do. Sit back. I give full permission for anyone to react to my top 5 list because I'm going to warn you, it is going to trigger some of you really hard because I rank some coasters higher or lower than they technically should be on a thrill scale. But again, I'm measuring them based off of multiple factors like comfort, theming, overall package for families and adults, and just the overall package at Canada's Wonderland. Anyways, number 5 on my list is Thunder Run. Right off the bat, some of you are probably like, how is Thunder Run in a top 5 coaster list at Canada's Wonderland? Well, it's got theming, it's indoors for a lot of it, it's got this really nice family feel, and I just like that it adds an actual unique difference to the coaster lineup at Canada's Wonderland. This will most certainly be knocked off my list in 2019, but for 2018, I had to give it an honorable mention for being an overall package for Canada's Wonderland. This coaster is really sought after by families. Number 4 on my list is Mindbuster, and I really didn't want to put this on my list. I don't know why. I was going to like swap it out with Backlot Stunt Coaster, but I sat down and I really just couldn't come up with a valid argument for my opinion on why Backlot Stunt Coaster deserved to be there instead of Mindbuster. So I gave Mindbuster its fair share of limelight in this video because it really is an overall somewhat decent coaster, except for its uncomfort. So it does rank really low on my comfort scale. In fact, you will not catch me on this roller coaster at Canada's Wonderland. I am a really tall dude and I am bigger, so riding this is extremely uncomfortable, and it's just, for my personal opinion, not an overall package at the current moment. Now, for those of you that do watch my videos, you do know that I have my eyes on this coaster for a 2021 or 2022, somewhere along that timeline, RMC conversion or GCI conversion. Something's going to happen to this coaster. It's in Frontier Canada. Mindbuster was always supposed to be the main attraction of Frontier Canada. Yukon Striker has taken that limelight, but I think to complete Frontier Canada, now that we know it's a multi-year expansion, they're going to want to do something to Mindbuster to up its ante. I think it's very clear that something's going to go on. They're still working on electrical and water plumbing in the area surrounding the coaster. And I think it would just really complement Frontier Canada if we have a really good wooden coaster. That also believes me to think that GCI may be the chosen company to come in and do Mindbuster because they might want to keep it wooden. But that's up for discussion right now. That's a whole separate video and discussion, so I won't go too much into that. But Mindbuster definitely comes in at number 4 for my top 5 coasters at Canada's Wonderland. Now, this is where it's going to get really, really triggering. At number 3, I have Leviathan. I am so sorry. I'm going to explain myself right now and why. In fact, Leviathan in 2017 would have been number 2 on my list. I'm going to explain why it's number 3 right now for 2018. I got to go to a really awesome event, an ACE event at Canada's Wonderland this year, and I got the best ride on Vortex I have ever had. I got the best rides, plural, on Vortex that I've ever had. This ride, Vortex, was swaying 90 degrees around turns. It was hauling so fast. You literally thought you were going to hit every support beam, every tree. You didn't think the brakes would be able to stop you. It was insane. And I promise you, you have to trust me, that anyone that was with me on that train can vouch that this thing was fast. It was fast. It was swaying like I've never seen Vortex sway before. And I get it. It was a colder day. It was later on in the summer. From what I understand, switched wheels. So it was a very unique experience. But for 2018 and my ride experience, I definitely have to say that I really enjoyed Vortex over Leviathan for that season. But these are two rides that can easily interchange for me. I get it. A lot of people's top ride at Wonderland is probably Leviathan, and I understand that as well. But I've been on a lot of Gigas, and by a lot, I've been on two. So to counter myself, I haven't been on a lot of Gigas. But the reason I do rank Leviathan low at Canada's Wonderland is it's just too similar to Behemoth for me. I've been on Millennium Force. I've been on Magnum. I've been on Behemoth. And I've been on a lot of rides that have the similar elements to Leviathan, and I just found Leviathan to be incomplete. It's missing something for me. It's missing that one extra element. When I compare it to Fury, Fury's a real Giga coaster in my opinion, and Leviathan's almost like that hyper coaster that dreamt of being a Giga coaster and it didn't quite get there. Yes, it's got the height. Yes, it's got the drop. And yes, those are fantastic things to have, but it's just missing that extra oomph to give it that top spot at Wonderland, in my opinion. I also would have liked to see some better theming in that tunnel. A little extra theming would have pushed this a little higher on my list, but I will say it's a very comfortable ride. It is definitely very thrilling. Wonderland didn't make a mistake with it, but in my perspective, it's just missing that extra little oomph, especially with such an amazing B&M Hyper on the other side of the park. It's really, really lacking that extra, like, airtime hills. I would have liked to see a lot more lower to the ground elements. And I would have liked to see it pull a little extra elements near the end, or even have that turnaround be slightly different. It's just way too similar to Behemoth, in my opinion. Now, coming in at number two, this is Vortex. Again, Vortex is at the number two spot for the reasons I just listed as to why I ranked Leviathan at number three. Vortex is amazing. This thing goes over a mountain, it goes through trees, it dips down into a ravine, and you come close to a close-to-water encounter. You're dodging support beams, you're going fast. This thing angles at like 90 degrees, 80 degrees, 7 degrees during turns. It is really amazing, and I think this is super underrated in Canada's Wonderland's lineup. It's a very old attraction, thus it drops on people's coaster lists because you've ridden it every year. And again, it would not have been in the number two spot in 2017. But in 2018, I had a really awesome ride experience, and I know the park is taking really good care of this coaster and plans on keeping it in their coaster lineup permanently if they can. So again, this coaster is super special to me. I think it's super unique for Wonderland. I like that it's unique. I like that it's not a B&M because we're getting a lot of B&Ms at Wonderland. And I like that it has this experience that you can't get on any other of the coasters. It's got the speed. Leviathan, again, is a speed coaster, but I find this a different kind of speed. It's not a B&M speed. And I think that's why I'm ranking it at number two. Feel free to drag me down below. Again, if anyone wants to react to my top five list, go for it. I totally understand why this is controversial. I understand why my opinions are, you know, not right. Again, I am a theme park enthusiast, not a coaster enthusiast. That's what I like to call myself. And this is a prime example as to why I'm probably more a theme park enthusiast and not a coaster enthusiast. But comment down below. I want to hear from you guys. What are your top three coasters at Canada's Wonderland, and how would you rank them? Would your number one be Leviathan or Behemoth? And what would your number two and number three be? So now with the Vortex being my number two coaster at Canada's Wonderland, you probably know what my number one is. My number one coaster at Canada's Wonderland is Behemoth. Now, I do know that this is a very controversial topic. Is Behemoth or Leviathan a better coaster? A lot of hardcore coaster enthusiasts even have trouble deciding between the two. I mean, I'm on a Discord call almost all day, and half of us think Behemoth is better. Half of us think Leviathan is better. None of us can come to an agreement on which one's better. But in my personal opinion, Behemoth just has that extra oomph that a B&M coaster needs to have that number one spot at a park. I like that it has a ton of airtime. I love that it has different elements. I like the helix. I like the extra little airtime hills into the brake run. Every aspect of this ride has airtime. So much so, at Ace Event, again, I got sick on this ride. I haven't gotten sick on a ride ever. I got so sick, I had to take an hour or 2 hour break before I could go on another ride, and I remained sick for the rest of the day. This is because of the airtime. So much airtime, especially as you get older and older, and I know that people watching this video who are coaster enthusiasts and are aging, like I am, you know, getting into their 20s and then getting into their 30s, understand that you are unable to do as many coasters and rides as you used to be able to. And trust me, Behemoth is one of those coasters that I cannot ride more than like 5 times in a day. Otherwise, my stomach is going to spill its guts. Anyways, Behemoth is just, in my opinion, an overall better package. It has that overall experience that I'm looking for, and I love it. It's right next to this little pond. It's stunning. I love that it reflects in the water. I love that it's like very small footprint, yet a big footprint at the same time. This thing is super photogenic, and overall, it's just the better coaster, in my opinion. Again, I totally understand if you think Leviathan is better. It's definitely one of those things that are no one's ever going to agree on fully. So with that, I want you guys to comment down below what you guys think is better. Is Leviathan better? Is Behemoth better? What's your top three at Canada's Wonderland? Feel free to share this video or react to it on YouTube. You have my permission. Anyways, hope you enjoyed my top five coasters at Canada's Wonderland. Again, I was ranking it on overall experience. These are not the top five most thrilling coasters at Canada's Wonderland. These are just the top five coasters, in my opinion, with the overall package. Hopefully you like this video. Give it a like, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for others to enjoy. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Enjoy your break. Bye.